I'm pro-vaccine. I'm just one of the unfortunate ones that got the Guillain-Barré.
This is one of many hospitals seeing a surge in COVID cases. In fact, here in Arkansas, COVID cases are up 77% in the last 2 weeks. All this as we learn more about that new warning for the Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
Federal officials warning the single-shot Johnson & Johnson vaccine may slightly increase the risk of a rare disease, Guillain-Barré syndrome, or GBS, where the body's immune system attacks nerve cells, causing muscle weakness and, in extreme cases, paralysis. The CDC investigating just 100 out of nearly 13 million doses. The symptoms showing up primarily in men aged 50 and older about 2 weeks after vaccination. Tom Gorman got the J&J vaccine in March. A couple weeks later, his legs started feeling weak. Then he lost the ability to walk. Emergency room tests revealed he had GBS.
I used to be very, very athletic, and now I'm confined to a wheelchair.
Gorman says he still thinks everyone should get vaccinated. According to officials, the syndrome has not been seen in people vaccinated with Moderna and Pfizer's mRNA shots, but officials also stressing the benefits of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine outweigh the risks. This as hospitalizations increased by at least 20% in 12 states over the last 2 weeks. In Arkansas, where less than 35% of the state's population is vaccinated, daily COVID cases have increased a whopping 385% in the last 5 weeks.
Most of the patients are between the ages of 20 and 50, and largely they are unvaccinated.
In Little Rock, where only 40% of Pulaski County is fully vaccinated, Angela Morris, hanging on to hope, talking to us from her daughter's hospital bedside.
Her kidneys have failed. It's all been very overwhelming.
13-year-old Kaya, who has not been vaccinated, is on a ventilator, fighting to stay alive. Her mother begging people to get the shot.
New accounts from the front lines of the massive firefight in the West, the extreme heat and record drought supercharging 58 major fires across the region. The Beckwith Fire north of Lake Tahoe, California, scorching about 90,000 acres. At least 20 homes destroyed, residents forced to flee with hardly any notice.
Those flames were coming at us like the headlight on a freight train.
We just left everything. There was nothing we can do. We had to get out.
More evacuations in Mariposa County, where the river fire now threatens a critical route into Yosemite National Park.
I hope everything is still there when I get back.
In southern Oregon, the bootleg fire has been threatening a major power grid that connects Oregon and California. The fire doubling in size every day for 3 days.